Swansea second in the merit table and taking on a club enjoying one of its most successful seasons. Abertillery, although out of the cup at an early stage, have nevertheless kept things going on a high note. But our commentator at Abertillery Park is Martin Williams. There's no score and the game is almost halfway through the first half.
On the halfway line. Taken at the front by Swansea. Tickley. Quite intended that way, I don't think. To Manley of Abertillery. That's neat play by Manley, taken by David Rees. A couple of encouraging runs by David Manley. Abertillery. By Tidley. With the juggling act. And here's David Manley showing a little bit of enterprise. Big little death clutch past Bernie Taylor. And Tidley's shoulder impeding the progress of the young Abertillery wing. 18 minutes of the first half gone. Still no score. Abertillery just inside the Swansea 22-metre line. The penalty to Abertillery. So the movement is on, the call has been made. Moves the pivot man to Lee Jones on the Priest, the number 8. And Abertillery will set it up. Moon on to Wilkinson. Good tackling by Swansea. Nunnally picks up. Has he got the strength to get there? Not quite there yet. Moon under Priest. And eventually a gap. A try scored by Robert Priest. That's his 18th of the season. A short penalty move. Lee Jones is the pivot man. And that's Priest with his first attempt. The setup was there. Nunnally just lying off, ready for the bulldozing charge, but Moon opting then for Wilkinson instead. Not quite there. Good talent tackle by John Thomas. But eventually, there were too many Abertillery men there. Onward the movement with Nunnally. Then the ball made available. Moon and on to Priest. The conversion by Ronnie Crane. Who else? And Abertillery into the lead, 6 points today. Williams with a throw, a hooker for the Welsh Universities. Williams to Titley, to Parfitt, and there's a gap on, and he's a bit of a sprinter, is Parfitt on to Titley, trying to bring him to Glenn Taylor. Taylor's still going, this is encouraging from Swansea. Oh, that's much better play by Swansea. Movement by the Swansea three quarters. I've given Richard Moriarty some encouragement. He turns his throw and the penalty goes to the All Whites. Swansea willing to run the ball at last, and it's rather noticeable in this movement that Parfitt and Titley and Redden Taylor combining are regulars in the first team. But good covering by Abertillery in the end. Kick taken by David Rees and Swansea at last on the scoreboard. David Rees, former secondary school's cap, who hails from Abercorn, which is not so far away from Abertillery. Just 3 points in it. Hugh Williams, a Swansea hooker, student at the local university. Is taken by Pitton for Abertillery. Someone's comparing that time and giving the free kick that there wasn't enough of a gap between the two sides. Accusing Abertillery of encroaching. And an opportunity for the All Whites. Tickley, the decoy of the drop goal under Parfitt. Evans to Glenn Taylor. It's as simple as that. A lovely try by Swansea. A good response. And that takes them into the lead. Pass to Titley. You notice the fade attempt and a draft goal, and then the gaps began to emerge. Parfitt, good running from him, on to David Evans, the youngster, and then Brevin Taylor going across for his 19th try of the season. 1 point in it, and that will make for an interesting game. The sunshine returning to Abertillery Park. Lee Jones with a throw. Abba Habit, Crane, a tester for David Rees. Took it well that time. And he's going to run the ball. The counter attack could be on. Williams onto the hooker. Hugh Williams. Away from the All Whites. Colclough in the middle. And moves to Bevan Taylor. They have a go, Hanley. Bloom. Colclough off for Andrew Bloom. Peace. Emergency scrum half on the Picton. A fair number of penalties being awarded by Gareth Simmons. And the Williams need to get on with the game. But Swansea content to ease his wind. And the decisions we made to have a go at 3 points. David Rees will know that he's got the strength of this wind up the valley towards Brimmel, but it's a fair distance of 50 metres. Rees. Struck it well, might even get there. Super kick by David Rees. Almost 50 metres. Not really drawing the applause around Abertillery Park that it merited.
Swansea number 15, David Rees.
Certainly it's been a match that has been dominated by the whistle, which is rather frustrating for all concerned. Enjoying just a 4 point lead at half time, but they'll have a slope in the second half. Who will join the match now at the beginning of the second half? Mark Titley to start the second half. And straight to Boone to Roddy Crane. Alan Williams just waiting for the luck of the bounce. Titley. Caught between two minds that time, the Welsh international wing. The pickup is by Rice for Abertillery. Moving the short side, he's got Walker outside. And getting away from the tackle of Richard Moriarty. Onto Robinson, looking for Manley. This is better play by Abertillery. But the ball was out. But on the other side, offside, and the penalty to the home side. Whatever Lee Jones said to the Abertillery side at half-time seems to work. Much more aggression in this move, especially by Rupert Moon. The Englishman at scrum half and then linking up. And you notice that Robinson just looking for the tower of the man, Stuart Nunnally. The charge is on. The Swansea offside as the ball is being made available. The penalty shouldn't be too difficult. For a man who scored 347 points last season, Roddy Crane, certainly gave it plenty of lift, almost like a wet shot, and a good immediate response by Abertillery after 2.5 minutes of playing in the second half, just 1 point. Good attacking position for the All Whites. John Thomas's control, Alan Williams, particularly the Parfitt. Now to Bernie Taylor on the charge. Held, but on goes Swansea. It's Mike Morgan. Alan Williams on the short side up to David Rees. There's a bit of a gap there. Rees might make it on his own. Superb try. Really well worked try by Swansea. Eventually scored by the fullback David Rees. The set move called by Swansea. Half it coming into the line, then the decoy. And onward goes Bernie Taylor. He might have had thoughts of going on his own, but support from Mike Morgan, then the setup, then Alan Williams, coming scrum half, knew there might be some space on the short side. Reese had support, but didn't need it. Try unconverted, unfortunate for David Reese, hitting the upright, but Swans will be well pleased with that scoreboard. Minutes into the second half. Williams with the throw, looking once again for Moriarty. Priest goes through from Abertillery. Boom. And away that Abertillery. It's Picton. Challenge is there from Rupert Boone. Now can Abertillery keep the momentum? On to Nunnally. Nunnally will surely get there with his block. He's there. Stuart Nunnally, 6'3" and 16 stone, making his presence felt. Let's not forget that Abertillery had been defending a couple of seconds earlier, but away goes Picton. Great support. The ball eventually getting to Moon. He's been a bit of a live wire for Abertillery. Then Abertillery desperately needing the possession. Nunnally saw the gap, and that was it. Stuart Nunnally, a prolific point scorer for Abertillery. That's his 13th try of the season. And this, from Barry Crane, could give Abertillery the lead. Indeed it does. 15 points to 14, a good recovery by the home side. Reese with the control, but it's untidy ball, and Swansea have it. Williams to Mark Tickley, on to David Evans. Good tackling by the Abertillery midfield. 13 is Wayne Evans trying to get away. And on goes Wilkinson, pick up by Moon, onto Walker. Richard Moriarty doing the captain's job. And Williams to Tipley, Stuart Parfitt to David Reese. Superb pass from Parfitt. As David Reese got the strength to get there, he's got Glenn Taylor outside. Taylor on the charge, up against Wilkins. Taylor will make it. That's a great try by Swansea. A great counter-attack, all of 70 metres. Gavin Taylor, the try scorer. Good ruck ball won by Swansea. And then the superb pass by Parfitt. That beat the entire Abertillery midfield. And then David Reese called upon to sprint, knowing full well that Taylor was there on hand if needed. Now it's all up to Gavin Taylor. Up against a bit of a sprinter in Mark Wilkins. Taylor making it for his second try of the afternoon. The try unconverted, but in this seesaw game, Swansea delighted to be back into the lead by 18 points to 50. Four on the line for Abertillery to Stuart Nunnally, five Jeff Robinson. Moriarty 21 on his back for Swansea. And the move not quite coming off, but a penalty to Abertillery. And a decision time for Lee Jones. That's the decision. Andy Crane to go for 3 points. And if successful, this will tie up the game. It's a fair distance to go. Good 36 metres and a tight corner. Struck it well. Might get there. It's there. It's all level at Abertillery Park. Everything to play for. Well, 3.5 minutes to go. Very clean. Once again, very much the hero. Makes the situation very interesting indeed. Everything to play for.
Now, Leeds went to St Helens, reinforced by the only unbeaten record in Wales. In sharp contrast, their opponent Swansea, anxious to recover from a dismal start and prove that Welsh rugby isn't as bad as it's been painted. Eddie Butler was there.
If Welsh rugby is ailing, then may the illness be long and painful. If, from the sport's sickbed, Swansea and Neath can produce a game like this, there seems little point in getting better. Today's match was quite simply superb. The only trouble was that both sides showed all the symptoms of being very much alive and kicking. Swansea started the better. Their forwards, ever considered flimsy, had new steel. Their backs, with Bredinville at outside half and Anthony Clement at fullback, had vision and adventure. And the All Whites took an early lead, 3-0, through a Bredinville in penalty. At first, Meath were as sluggish as the traffic in Swansea City Centre, which made just about everybody late for the game. And once they got going, they were their usual selves. And once the All Blacks were into their stride, it seemed that the game would turn their way, especially when the opposition began kicking away good line-up possession from Richard Moriarty. Paul Thorburn, in another head-to-head with Anthony Clement, out to prove once more that he is more than a kicker. The pace of the game was becoming faster and faster, and it seemed that all the speed of thought was coming from Neath. Swansea, besides looking a little clumsy, were unlucky to be penalised. Paul Moriarty apparently obstructing Paul Williams. But all the early adventure from the home side was now substituted by an increasingly desperate defence. The Leaf back row of Mark Jones, Gerald Williams and Roland Phillips were only too willing to run at the heart of the stretched defence. Paul Thorburn again showing an equal determination to join in the attacking spree. Sometimes it took Meath a little time to gather momentum, but still they retained possession. And somebody was always on hand to inject the thrust of power, Jeremy Pugh this time. And then Roland Phillips. Behind the forwards, Paul Williams tried to vary the style of attack. But Redden Taylor did well together. And his clearance offered Swansea the breathing space they so very badly needed at this stage. From the ensuing line-out, Chris England, not always successful against Hugh Richards at the front, won the ball. Any hope seemed then to be lost. But then Tim Michael started on a run inspired by his left leg. Inside to Bevin Bowen. And again, things seemed to have come to nothing. But Bevin Taylor then revealed his attacking powers, following up Adrian Williams' kick, and timing his inside pass to Anthony Clement to perfection. And Clement wasn't finished yet. Thorburn himself would have been proud of it. 9-0 the score. Back came Neath immediately. The tactics remained the same, setting up the charges close to the ruck. Mark Jones, and how badly he felt the need to touch the ball on the floor. Jeremy Pugh was next. Only now, the tackling looked a little suspect. And anywhere that Tim Michael's left leg could carry him, Richie Griffiths could do the same. Paul Thorburn with a conversion, 9-6 the score. Swansea had a few charges of their own. Richard Moriarty in the line-out, and Alan Reynolds outstanding throughout the match, giving Neath a touch of their own medicine. Swansea a bit clumsy again with their feet at two successive rucks, meaning that the backs didn't have the quick ball they required. But Neath were even more guilty, killing the ball on the ground. Score 6. The confidence had now returned to Swansea's play. Their scrimmaging was solid, and even from deep inside their own half, they were prepared to move the ball wide. Clement's pace, a key factor in giving Blevin Taylor room. Now the following up tackling should have been better, but Paul Forbin did marvellously well to clear. But still, the tide seemed to be swinging Swansea's way. Richard Moriarty with yet more possession of the line-out. And now Brother Paul joined in the fun. This is what he likes best, the ball in his hand. Tim Michael once again set up the opportunity, but Swansea had been drifting across the pitch, and this wouldn't be the first time they squandered a great chance. But still, the All-Whites stood only feet from the neath line. Boo's kick seemed harmless enough. At first, Clement's control was first class. But then, disaster. Alan Edmonds reducing the deficit, 12-10 now. The new steel in Swansea's approach now revealed itself. Good pace from Robert Jones going outside Gerald Williams. Support from all the back row, Paul Arnold, Alan Reynolds and Paul Moriarty. ...16-10 the score. In the second half, the wind was with Neath, and Swansea knew they would need more points before the inevitable onslaught began. They began battering away. No mistakes were being made. Blevin Taylor crossing in front of Blevin Bowen. Swansea used the short side. Robert Jones to Robert Subiani, breaking some high tackles. And then the open side. But still the mistakes came. First the pass. And then Anthony Clement killing a man without the ball. And from the centre of the field, they used their initial options well. Adrian Williams heading right, feeding Subiani again. And some more high tackles. Swansea not able to secure the vital ruck ball. Before Robert Jones had a chance to put his high kick up, he was awarded a free kick for foot up. On the charge, but after that, play tended to drift across the pitch. Jonathan Griffiths kicking through. Jones and Clement combined well. Clement showed just how elusive he can be in a tight space. The cross kick looked good, but now Meath had the chance to regain themselves a breathing space. Penalty for offside. The pattern of play was to alter again. Under pressure in the scrums, Neath somehow managed to keep driving close to the fringes in the loose. Roland Phillips made the maul into a ruck. And Paul Williams' chip was inch perfect for Alan Edmonds. Andrew Booth cleverly keeping the ball in play. And finally, it was close to the fringes that the neat breakthrough was to come. Jones held, but the pass inside to Roland Phillips. All the score, the odds now stacked in Neath's favour. Where once Robert Jones had been making ground, he was now losing the ball. And Neath were taking full advantage. Booth to Edmonds. Back to Booth. Inside to Gerald Williams. Finally into touch. How ironic it should be that Neath should have a chance to take the lead for the man who had denied them ball all afternoon, Richard Moriarty. Season and his side now led by 19 points to 16. What the match really needed was an explosive climax, and he certainly got it. Paul Moriarty found the blind side blocked, and then Tim Michael found that his left leg could again carve holes in the open side. Swansea now led. But the drama wasn't over yet. Neath came back into the Swansea 22. But here they were struggling to make any progress. Defenders around, and Alan Reynolds just couldn't stop himself from killing the ball. It was ready made for the man who had won third places in the World Cup and triple crowns for Wales. But just for once, the right boot failed, and Swansea had clung on for a famous victory. Better advert for Welsh rugby will take a long time to find.
Terrific stuff, and that surprising result knocks Neath off the top of our championship table. Newbridge go there instead, but only just on superior points difference. With a National League on the horizon, just for a bit of fun, we split the 18 first-class clubs into two divisions to give you some sort of rough idea of how it would look under a promotion relegation system. Always assuming, of course, that the Whitbread clubs and the Welsh Rugby Union stop rowing about it. Despite the win, Swansea still in the lower half and therefore the second division. If they were to be sure of being in the first division, they would have to finish in the top nine. On to today's best performances. Pride of place to Llanelli captain